getting a second command center and its national expansion. And looks like three lurkers being made here, and two evolution chambers. So he's thinking about getting his upgrades for Carapace at least, and possibly for Millie. And we see here, Zerg still holding the middle area, forcing C to go around if he wants to do a scout. And now the two lurkers are coming out. They're going to be spotted by C, and C's actually going to chase them back right now with those medic marines. Caught a little off guard there, and Yell's going to be forced to retreat a little bit, perhaps get some more Zerg marines to help them. And now he's actually taking a defensive posture, leaving the wounded lurker at his natural to defend. And he's going to be dealing with about 12 medic marines and fire vets here, and more being produced. A factory going down for C, so he's thinking of getting higher tech. And two lurkers actually going around the left side of the map, and they're going to use the wide ramp instead of the narrow bridge. They're going to perhaps try to flank this force here, but the force retreats just in time to prevent being flanked from behind. That would have been a big loss for C if he had caught off guard. But these lurkers are now going to try to set up a contain, it seems, at the sort of the third base here of the Terran, just to prevent the Terran from moving out easily. And it looks like Yarnak is going to send out a drone here, perhaps to set up a second expansion. He's still got Zerglings wandering the map here, just taking a look at what C's up to. C's getting commsats, it seems, so he's going to at least have those against the lurkers. Looks like he's stimming his marines here. I wonder what he's trying to hunt down. Oh, he's just going to hunt down that one Zergling there. Anyway, so it'll be interesting to see if Yarnak decides to go for a spire here, or if he decides to just build up a large lurker force and perhaps go directly behind. Looks like his second expansion is spotted by C there at the 11 o'clock corner. We'll see if C does something about it, but it's quite difficult to reach that expansion. You have to basically... Actually, no, there are two ramps leading to that expansion, so you could go from the left side of the map. In any case, those lurkers, I think, are stop position. Yes, I think those are stop lurkers, because they didn't attack the SAV when they were in range. So there's two stop lurkers there from Yarnak, and we'll see if he can beat C into attacking and losing a lot of his medic marine force. And looks like C is moving out. This might be stop lurkers here. This could be really good here. I always love to see these little tricks here, and Yarnak being a little tricky with those two lurkers. They're in a really good position on top of that hill to attack both of those ramps. And in stop position, there's no way of knowing they're there unless you scan them beforehand. And they can attack while your marines are in a perfect position and get killed by two rows of spines. Basically, one shot will kill them from two lurkers. And it looks like Yarnak's going for Hive right now. C is going to spot that as main. And he's got more lurkers coming in here, so C is, Yarnak is foregoing his spire for a Hive immediately. We'll see if he decides to get Defilers first and just stick to his Zergling Defiler lurker force. And C is steadily moving up here. If he decides to go up the left side, I think he will be dealing with that pair of stomp lurkers, and that will be interesting. And C actually has... his science center, science facility, and it looks like he's going to be making some science vessels here from his starport. Could be dropships, I guess. Five lurkers now blocking the way, and C's not going to be able to break that with that medic marine force there. He's going to have to wait for science vessels and irradiate, or get some tanks to really break through here against all these lurkers. And more drones being ferried across to the 11 o'clock position. C actually has a large force here, about 24 medic marines, or perhaps a little more. And it's still not going to be enough, I think, to deal with those lurkers. I don't think it'll be worth it for him to attack, but he is going for the attack here. Wow, actually killing two of the lurkers and forcing the other three to flee backwards. C has a large force here, but and he has 0-1 upgrade, so it's one attack upgrade against 1-1 Zerglings here and 1-0 lurkers. In case you can't see it on the video, that's what the upgrades are. So the Zergling melee attack is being upgraded. He's going to be focusing on a crackling build here, and I think these Zerglings are Adrenal Grind upgraded, so they're going to have a fast attack. And he's got a small group of Zerglings wandering in the back there, perhaps forcing C to pull back his medic marine force, just buying some more time. And I expect Defilers to be coming soon. That would make the most sense, given his unit combination so far. And C going for really the SK Terran build here, getting just medic marines with science vessels, skipping all factory units in between. And he's got 6 barracks going up, 7 barracks going up, so really getting his macro up here. He's going to produce a lot of forces pretty soon. And we'll see if he decides to set up a second expansion here. Now Aspire going up for Yarnak. I'm guessing he's going to try to get some Scourge here to deal with the science vessels that he can expect coming soon. And now he's getting a third expansion at the 9 o'clock position, and just getting a creep colony to protect his main. That's a good idea against any incoming drops. That one sunken colony would be quite helpful. So C still has he has 2 groups of forces, one on the left and right, just to intercept any incoming forces from Yarnak. And it looks like his science facility was flashing, so I'm guessing he's getting irradiated right now for his science vessels. And yeah, large groups of medic marines at 3 places now for C. And I still don't know if those lurkers are in stop position. They could be. Hold position or whatnot. Now Factory being lifted up to a little scout. He's got 3 science vessels now, and he's going to be able to push out fairly soon here. A Defiler Mound finally going down for Yarnak. I feel like he could have gotten that Defiler Mound a little sooner, right after you finish this line, to really get those Defilers out, because they really just multiply the power of your Zergans and Lurkers. They're just such a great force multiplier. And now these hold position Lurkers are just going to be irradiated and spotted by the science vessels, so unfortunately they weren't able to be used before then. And now the science vessels pushing in here. Marines and medics going up this ramp here. They're going to get hit by a couple Zergans and that one remaining lurker, but they managed to take them out fairly easily. And now he's moving into the 9 o'clock position here. The Scourge don't kill a science vessel. There's still 3 lurkers there, but they're getting irradiated. And he's only got 1 sunken and 2 one lurker that's going to be left, and no lurkers left now. Just Zerglings defending this base, and they're not going to be able to hold this 9 o'clock position. So Yarnak in quite a bit of trouble here. There's just such a large medic marine force that he's going to have to retreat all of his drones here, and he's going to lose his factory fairly quickly. And now his 11 o'clock corner is at risk here. They're going up that ramp, like I said, there's 2 ramps leading up to there, and they're going up the ramp on the bottom there, and some colonies aren't up yet. Good force of Zerglings coming out here. Oh wow, they actually caught the medic marines in transit before all the forces come together, and they take out like about half of them, all the firebats, and most of the marines actually. So a really good move by Yarnak there, attacking at the perfect time and taking out what he needed to do. And now Scourge chasing those science vessels. There's going to be fewer marines to protect them, and C wisely keeps the science vessels over.